Welcome to the highlights of the third of the Benson Hedges World Series Cup preliminary matches. This one, the first international fixture of its kind played in Tasmania. West Indies against Sri Lanka, and a very good crowd present at the start of the day. The Benson Hedges World Series Cup table, after the first two matches have been played, the West Indies have 2 points and Australia two, but the Australians have also played two matches. Cold and rather blustery day at the TCA ground in Hobart. The wind whipping in from the southwest and a temperature of only about 18 degrees. Tony Gregg reported the pitch was in good shape, although it looked as though it might have a lot of life in it in at least the first hour. Quite a bit of grass on it out there and one or two undulations as well. Viv Richards, who was acting as captain of the West Indies in the place of Clive Lloyd, won the toss and put Sri Lanka into bat. We pick up play now with the third ball of the first over. Marshall is the bowler, coming into bowl to Weta Mooney, and your commentators are Ian Chappell and Bill Lurie.
It's a good shot, and it's a very short boundary out there. It's also down the hill, and Weta Mooney gets the Sri Lankan score moving with a magnificent boundary.
Garner to Silva.
Landing just in front of Viv Richards. And Amal Silva off the mark.
Yes, that was a genuine edge. Richards moved late. Didn't quite carry, but he didn't seem to move too. Very late. The ball angled across the left-hander. Opened the face. Well short of Vivian Richards. He did well to knock that down.
Well, that's a good delivery. He's beaten not only the batsman, but Geoffrey Dujon with a magnificent leg cutter. So it finishes up being a very good over for Sri Lanka. It's none for nine after two. Once again, tremendous bounce there for Garner. And Weta Mooney has taken it on the fingers. He got one the other night in Sydney on the fingers.
That's a brutal delivery. Did well to keep it down in the end. And he's going very close to the stumps today.
Wide of Dujon. Malcolm Marshall is a fine leg. And that was off the glove. Looking across there at the skyline. And life has been made very difficult at the moment for both the Sri Lankan batsman and Geoffrey Dujon.
What a beautiful delivery. Malcolm Marshall bowling to the left-hander. Bolt his leg cutter to the right-hander, but that's the one that comes back to the left-hander, and it moved a mile. Look at a swing as well. No hope for Dujon.
Garner to Silva.
Well, and that's a tremendous delivery. Well taken by Geoffrey Dujon, and that ball coming off the glove. And Amal Silva didn't even hang around to wait for the umpire. He was on his way. A brute of a delivery.
Certainly seemed unfair, that delivery. He's very close to the stumps. He's bowling at middle and leg at cut. Got a glove or a handle, and Dujon took a fine catch. Fine piece of bowling, and I'll silver out for four, but no discredit to him. Great piece of bowling from Joel Garner.
And Karupu off the mark as he picks out Michael Holding. Geoffrey Dujon there chasing after that delivery, or after that return from Michael Holding.
Garner to Weta Mooney. Must be out. Vivian Richards. Straightforward catch. Weta Mooney goes, and Joel Garner is posing awful problems out there this morning on a very lively surface.
Not only is Garner getting movement off the wicket, such as this, away from the bat, he's also getting lift, and Weta Mooney there just exasperated, going for the off drive, was never on, found the edge of the bat, and that went very quickly, about chest height to Viv Richards. So, Siddharth Weta Mooney out, caught Richard Bell Garner 8, and the second wicket is down.
Courtney Walsh is the bowler. Brendan Croup, who takes strike.
And the first ball from Courtney Walsh there. And umpire Isherwood just answering in the negative to that appeal, as that ball obviously moved a lot off the seam. Possibly just passing down the leg side.
Just misjudged, I think. For one moment, Michael Holding thought it was coming straight down his throat, and then all of a sudden it was carrying on with the breeze. Would have been a remarkable catch had he pulled it off, but he was coming in for the catch and then had to change tack and go sideways and back as well.
Courtney Walsh again. And Kupu there just moving inside the line of the ball.
That's been signalled as byes, and Geoffrey Dujon is shaking his head whether with his own difficulty in getting to it or whether because he thought it just flicked the pad on the way through. It's arguable.
And that's the third time that four byes have been signalled.
Roy Dias takes strike to Michael Holding.
Roy Dias there just getting the ball away through point. He's very chest on. That ball must have moved off the seam away from him.
That's well caught. Very safe pair of hands, Richie Richardson, and brilliant hands as well, as we saw during the Test match series.
And a man who is very agile. That ball looked as though it might have dropped short of him. Off the shoulder of the bat, Brendan Croup, but Richardson coming forward gets his hands underneath the ball, quick to perceive the ball dropping. And he completes an excellent catch to send Croup back to the pavilion for eight. So the third wicket is down and Sri Lanka in trouble.
Here's Courtney Walsh now to Duleep Mendes.
Well, he gets off the mark, but it was not what you might call the best of shots.
And Courtney Walsh, good look at those three stumps then. Just getting the edge of that bat onto the ball. Away fairly quickly, but he really is giving the bowlers a good look at those stumps.
And that's off the outside edge, but it's gone away and could go away for four. It does. So Duleep Mendes brings up the 50 with a fortunate shot, but nevertheless he went for it and got four.
An unorthodox shot by the Sri Lankan captain, giving himself plenty of room. He's done that throughout this short inning so far, opening the face of the bat and going out to that backward point area.
And he's locked that right back over the bowler's head, and that'll go for four more.
Beautifully struck. That one was a much better shot. Courtney Walsh having a good look at those stumps, pitching up just a little further and straight down the ground. Unorthodox footwork from Mendes, but very profitable.
Richards to Duleep Mendes.
A bit of misfielding out there. And they'll get a second as Malcolm Marshall just fumbles. Just over the head of Gus Logie. Little man. And he couldn't quite make it. Cover. Gus Logie, who is having his first big match of the season.
Mendes once again deciding to go over the top of the infield. A little bit of luck there for him. If that had been Joel Garner out there, he may have well been on his way back to the pavilion, but it wasn't.
It's his seventh over, so it looks as if Richards is going to go all the way through his 10 overs in succession with Walsh. And that's lifted over the head of square leg. That's a lovely shot by Dias. He really put little effort into that shot and just lifted it over mid-wicket for four.
Courtney Walsh bowling in swingers, just straying onto the leg stump. A well-calculated shot by Roy Dyce. Just one bounce over the boundary.
Chase here for Larry Gomes. And he just gets around and fumbles it. Well, the vice-captain there, a blemish against his fielding record. Had it in control, got around well. And then when he got there, couldn't hold on.
Sloppy piece of fielding down the boundary by Larry Gomes. Bit of a bad bounce there. Ran quite nicely until it got about a yard in front of him. Then a little kick bounce. Took him on the wrist and went for four.
To be getting away from the pace bowlers. I'm sure we'll give them a little bit of breathing space and relief. They're going to have to make the most of Richards. Two there to Dyce. A man at deep mid on, one at deep square leg and one at deep fine leg. No one back on the offside. That's where he wants to hit them. And that one running away down to backward point for four. So he's got a really good eye. Anything short, he's going to flay away outside off stump, and when it's pitched up as well, he's going to look to hit it over the top in that area.
Yes, he's playing beautifully. It's not the perfect technique, but it's a great method. He's worked out if it's short, he's going to hammer it over point. There are three men on the onside boundaries, a square leg, backward square leg and deep fine leg, but he's withdrawing to the leg side. And young Courtney Walsh gave him some room on that occasion, and he hit that beautifully. Well played.
It's in the air, but into the gap. Made away on the onside for one. And that's the 50 partnership. So this is a very useful partnership for the Sri Lankans.
As Tommy cuts, and he does it well. Races out backward a point for four runs. I do recommend this. He's prepared to play his shot. Spins up the 100. The experienced campaigner, he went forward and then he leaned back and rocked and hammered it through point.
There he goes again, straight into the gap. That's not good bowling by Viv Richards. You cannot bowl off spinners short and outside off stump to this bloke, or in fact to anybody.
Hit that well. This gave him a bit of room, was a bit of bounce, and away it went. Very good tactics.
He's hit that down the ground. Gomes is moving around to his right. It won't get down to him. Certainly not on the full. So two more to Mendes, and I'm sure he's enjoying this little innings against Vivian Richards in particular. Only 40 balls for his 33 runs. He's hit that straight down the ground. That may be six. It is. Beautiful shot. Over the top of mid-off, way down the boundary there. A lovely straight hit.
Excellent tactics and a pause from Roy Dyce as well. The captain taking the attack up to the other opposing captain. He gave himself a little bit of room. He hit it full face of the bat over mid-off. A big hit. Excellent shot. Beautifully placed. 16 runs off. Four deliveries.
Here he goes again. He loves it on that offside. Moving backwards he is, giving himself lots of room. Hitting it down to the deep extra cover boundary. 20 runs of that over from Viv Richards in Sri Lanka, 3 for 116.
Walsh to Roy Dyce.
Oh, and a big appeal there. He's given out. Roy Dyce out, caught by Jeffrey Dujon off the bowling of Courtney Walsh. And that's a big wicket for the West Indians.
Good delivery. Just trying to work it through the offside. Plenty of bounce still. Dujon took a straightforward catch and a vital breakthrough. It was a good partnership. Roy Dyer is showing us again. He's a fine batsman out for 28.
And that's over the top as well. He hasn't hit one that one quite as well, though. And so they'll only get two. Just Logie. It's a back right over the top of the stumps. Viv Richards is going to continue bowling his off-spinners. Just a few slight adjustments to the field. It looks as if he's going to attack leg stump a little bit more aggressively. He'll have to keep it up as well, otherwise he'll go. That's one hit beautifully again, straight down the wicket, and it was really middle.
That
really did sound lovely and sweet at the back.
Oh, beautiful shot, Tony. Hit it on the up, hit it straight, brings up his 50. Very well played. Dewitt Mendes, he's taking the attack up to the West Indies. That was well placed. The full face of the bat, the follow through. Generous round of applause.
He's not going to stop there either. That one, he's got away down to square leg. He may get four more. He does. Well, I don't know whether the Viv Richards is going to be smiling for much longer. There was a little smile on his face when they took 20 off the over. Well, that's disappearing pretty quickly.
Well, that's eight off two deliveries. The first one was a massive off drive. That one was whipped away backward to square.
That's short, and he's pulled that away over the top of the infield. A little lucky to get away with it, mind you. Richard standing there with his hands on his hips.
Ruck favours the brave, and rightly so. Mendes going after him again. He pushed it through. It was almost medium pace. Didn't quite get hold of it, but picks up another single.
I think as he ran past Richards there, he might have apologised, just in case he brings the quicks back again. Aravinda De Silva has the strike, and I suppose Viv will try and keep it that way. Well, he's got that away. He's running quite quickly away down to deep fine leg. Desmond Haynes chasing away down there. They're coming back for the third. This might be close. He's going to be out. He's gone. Biles. Oh, what a disaster that was. He's played such a lovely hand as well. The captain of Sri Lanka, Dilip Mendes, out run out.
Well, he was after the strike. He was looking for that third run. It was never really on. He's not quick between the wickets. And Desmond Haynes with a very good throw. Caught him out just inside the rope. For anybody else but Mendes, it was three. He was very, very slow. An excellent return, and the captain run out at the end of a great innings. Big round of applause as he parts here. Sat in, 56 run out for Dewitt Mendes.
Holding to Ravi Ratnayake.
Shy at the stumps there by Richards, and that must have been pretty close. Well, he was just allowing the ball to pass past the front of him there, and could well have resulted in him being run out.
What a magnificent piece of work. Vivian Richards, the best all-round fieldsman you'll ever see. He comes in, picks it up, turns and throws, and the batsman just home. But what a brilliant piece of work.
Consider conditions here, and another boundary coming up as the left-hander, Ravi Ratnayake, cutting one away there from Michael Holding. It's very small ground and quite a fast outfield.
Richards to Ravi Ratnayake.
Oh, he's got him, attempting to pull the shorter, faster delivery, and the batsman perhaps believing that he'd heard a no-ball call or something, but he waited for the umpire to signify the fact that he was out bowled.
Quite extraordinary. You very rarely see the umpire have to give a batsman out bowled, but there was obviously some misunderstanding out there. And in-swinger there, not as short as Ravi Ratnayake thought. He'd attempted to pull to square leg. Saw his wicket go over. I rather agree with you, Ian. I think he must have heard a call of no-ball from somewhere in the crowd. Anyway, he's out. Bowl Richards for eight.
Ramesh Ratnayake faces Richards. Viv Richards to De Silva.
And there's the shot that he attempts to loft over the covers, but unfortunately he's picked out that marvellous fielder Roger Harper in the covers. And nothing gets by him.
And Roger Harper immediately into the action as soon as he comes onto the field to replace Gordon Greenidge. That open blade again, the open face there, leading to the downfall of De Silva there as he slices that ball into the safe hands of Roger Harper. So he's out court sub, Bill Richards for eight.
Aravinda De Silva well caught there by Harper. Oh, and there's the backhand. Well, I don't know that you'd actually call it a cut, seeing it's been played off about the leg stump. It's almost the backhand leg glance. 7 for 153.
Garner comes in now to Rumesh Ratnayake.
Off the edge and just wide of Geoffrey Dujon, and beats the outstretched boot of the third man, goes over the boundary line, and a much needed four to Sri Lanka takes them to 159.
Substitute fielder on for Gordon Greenidge.
And the run rate dropping back in that last over. It was 3.79. Dropped back to 3.73. Up to four runs and over at one stage.
Well, that's gone miles in the air, high up, and it may be safe. Will it be? Oh, well caught. No, it wasn't. I think that may well have gone over the boundary. Taken down there by Michael Holding. But he's gone over the line.
And that's the type of hitting the Sri Lankans needing. On this occasion, coming from the bat of Yuravay Karanane, hoiking it over that mid-wicket area, Michael Holding charging around the boundary. Looked as though he had it for a moment, and then just helping it over the line for six runs.
Garner comes in now to Rumesh Ratnayake.
He's done it. Over the top there, down towards square leg. Hasn't quite hit it in the middle of the bat, and Desmond Haynes will prevent it from going for four.
Pretty difficult to hit a boundary on that side of the ground today.
Malcolm Marshall to Rumesh Ratnayake.
Well played. He smashed that through extra cover. On the up, in fact. Gus Logie, very quick down there, managing to get the ball back and then having to hurdle the Toyota sign down there. Threw it right over the top. What a lovely throw. Desmond Haynes struggling a little bit. He may have distressed his knee.
It was a good save by Gus Logie. Short, quick man. Did the right thing then. Had an eye on the sign. Hurdled it. Picked up by Desmond Haynes. It looked as though he may have just pulled a muscle as he was chasing that.
Watch his face and hand. There it is. His hand goes down to his leg there. And you can see by the look of his face at that stage that he's got a few problems. Oh, he's hit that miles. That's gone way over the top of the crowd, down into the groundsman's backyard. What a big six that was.
Massive six from Yuravay Karanane. What a way to finish the innings off. Short delivery from Malcolm Marshall. A good pull shot. These short boundaries plonked it right over, not only over the boundary, but also the people on the edge of the boundary.
Played down to Gomes, who once again allows the ball to come to him and tries to throw it over the top of the stumps, but doesn't realise that jog on, in fact, wasn't there.
A bit of poor cricket then, too, from the Sri Lankans. Should have taken off for the single. Looked as though it was going to carry down to Larry Gomes. It didn't. But not picking a run up from this shot. Not good cricket. Must try and take some risks.
7 for 197 and one ball to go now in this Sri Lankan innings. It's been a tough day for them so far. As we've said, the pitch has been pretty quick and certainly been hit around the body and on the fingers a fair bit. And that's hit straight down the ground. Logie stretches his hand out there. Winston Davis is on the ground as 12th man. And he manages to cut it off. They get two. And so Sri Lanka end up 7 down for 199.
Well, that wasn't a bad effort in the end, 197 for the West Indies after they were caught on a very, very lively pitch early on. I thought Mendes played well, but overall it was a rather scratchy-looking scoreboard at the end of the innings. Mendes 56 and Roy Dias 28, two of those in double figures. Then Yuravay Karanane not out 20 and Rumesh Ratnayake not out 24. A partnership there at the end of 51 unbroken in 11 overs and only half an hour, so that gave the innings a little respectable touch. The West Indian bowlers, Marshall, well, he bowled very well, none for 38, no reward there for some super bowling. Garner 2 for 19 in 10 overs and one maiden. Holding a wicket was almost unplayable at one stage earlier this morning, so too Garner. Walsh was more expensive, 1 for 47 from 10 overs, and Richards 2 for 51 in 10 overs and two maidens. So 198 to win for the West Indies, and they have a full 50 overs in which to do it. We pick up play now with the first ball of the second over. It's Ravi Ratnayake coming in to bowl to Desmond Haynes. Your commentators, Tony Gregg and Ian Chappell.
Ravi Ratnayake starts with a half volley, which Desmond Haynes gives some fearful hammer to.
That is a beautiful shot by Desmond Haynes. Mind you, it was quite a friendly delivery. Have a look at it. Just short of a length, and in fact, it was a half volley, just a little bit wide, and smashed through extra cover all the way along the ground.
And a similar sort of delivery, bit of outswing, but Haynes just hitting with the swing. He's in tremendous form. He scored a century at the MCG and carrying right on here at the TCA ground. He hasn't started too well here at the TCA ground. Three boundaries coming in his first over.
There's another lovely shot on that occasion. The ball from Ravi Ratnayake, very short. And Desmond Haynes having no trouble rolling around and pulling it away down onto the ground and into the square leg boundary.
Once again, the one that straightens up, giving the batsman a problem.
But notice that ball swinging in and then just holding up a little bit.
Ravi Ratnayake has really got to sort himself out. It's high in the air, it'll fall safe. Wasn't a very good ball. And Haynes a little fortunate to get a single. It's none for 20.
John comes in to bowl to Haynes.
There's another nice shot from Desmond Haynes. That ball going down the leg side, certainly on leg stump, and played away nicely by him. Rolling the wrists on it and hitting it all the way along the ground. Just backward as square. There's no one down there, and so four more to him.
There'll be four more. Really is a short boundary down there, and the ground also slopes in that direction.
There's another short ball and hit away very firmly by Desmond Haynes.
The last couple of overs have been a bit better from the Sri Lankan opening bowlers. That's high in the air and out, taken in the gully there. Well, Desmond Haynes is grabbing at his arm. The Sri Lankans are quite bemused by the fact that it hasn't been given out. I must admit, I thought it sounded like a bit of bat.
As Desmond Haynes indicated that had hit him on the arm before it was caught. There it goes, and you notice he played the shot a bit too quickly. Up it went in the air, and nicely taken.
But I got the distinct feeling that there was a wooden noise first, and I haven't heard about Desmond Haynes having a wooden arm. There's the top edge, onto the arm, and then up into the gully.
Ravi Ratnayake and now to Greenwich.
That's safely away, wide of the skipper at mid-on. And Mendes restricts it to just a brace. West Indies, none for 32. Desmond Haynes on 23, facing Vinort and John.
Haynes gets it away. Four more, he's very strong off his pads. Haynes deflects nicely. What a great one-day player he is.
Well, we saw that shot played so frequently at the MCG on Sunday during his century there. An undefeated 123. And that's his seventh boundary in this innings. That's the first time we've seen him use that shot. That running it down into the vacant slips area. In the West Indies, when he got those three centuries in the four one-day matches, it was a shot which got him a lot of runs. Expertly played.
Vinort and John now bowling to Gordon Greenidge.
Shot. Beats mid-wicket.
Yeah.
That's the over bowled. It's no wicket for 48.
Rumesh Ratnayake to Greenwich.
Up without loss, very good start. They're pacing themselves, need 198 for victory. Free team gone, yes, got an edge. Good delivery, the outswinger. That was the break they needed. A divided Sri Lankan side rushes in and Rumesh breaks through. Very good delivery.
Well, that really squared him up. Haynes looking to play it down towards mid-on, shuffling behind it, and the late movement, just finding the outside edge, and that's gone. And there was the man who was really going. Now Desmond Haynes out for 32, and the West Indies are 1 for 50.
Richie Richardson is the batsman. Here's Ravi Ratnayake.
Richardson gets it away, fine. And that's four. He just can't afford to bowl leg stump to Richie Richardson. That's his strength. Whether it's square or fine, he got plenty of bat onto that one. Confident start.
Really picked this off very well. Fine. And even De Silva, the fastest man on the side, couldn't pick it up. Good bit of fielding by that youngster.
He's gone for that one over cover. It's a very confident shot. That's four more, nine runs off the over. It's 1 for 59.
Rumesh Ratnayake to Greenwich.
Well bowled, a bit of bounce, but gets enough bat on it to pick up two runs. Greenwich struggling between the wickets, and it goes for four. That's how short and fast this outfield is. It was a very thick edge, and Greenwich hobbled away for the second run, but it raced off to the boundary.
Yes, how short and fast the boundary is. And also, I think, how slow the fielder is at third man. He didn't get a run at all. He had plenty of time to make it, and he came pretty close. None of the diving which we've seen from the Australians. Gordon Greenwich picking up a boundary.
Greenwich gets that one away, his favourite pull shot. And he races out for four runs. It's 72 for one.
Didn't quite time that. Mendes is the fielder.
Going for three. Gordon Greenwich just accelerating a little bit at the end there. Been a real battle out here for Gordon Greenwich in more ways than one today, battling that injury that he's got, which is held him back running between the wickets. But he's also terribly out of form. That last delivery, I would have thought that early in the season, Greenwich would have put that away quite simply for four.
Would have been a great catch, Aravinda De Silva.
Rumesh Ratnayake could have quite easily have picked up his second wicket. Getting off the ground, just the one hand to it. But that was struck a little better by Greenwich. Just forced its way through that right hand. So a let off for him. Rumesh Ratnayake again from the northern end.
Attempted slower ball, a little bit too far with that one. Mendes, the skipper, is the fielder. Three to Richie Richardson. Gordon Greenwich is limping even more heavily now. One for 84. There's a good shot, straight over mid off. Just a few yards inside the boundary. Nicely played. He didn't hit across it at all. Once he made up his mind to go for it, just went through with the stroke.
A big decision to make here at the TCA Oval is to make sure when you hit it in the air, you hit it with the wind. And that one then, once it got into the air, and the wind behind it, just a couple of bounces, and four runs.
Curran to Richardson.
And the youngster will be bowling with a slight cross breeze, assisting any outswing. It's in the air and dropped at point.
That's Rumesh Ratnayake at point, putting down what was a relatively simple chance.
And Carnet will remember his first ball in the Benson Hedges World Series cut for a long time. As Richard Richardson goes for that cut, fails to get over the top of it. And it's put down at point. Rumesh Ratnayake, the culprit.
Greenwich not having any trouble with the square cut. Places it beautifully, and they really do race down that hill. That brings up the 50 stand.
And the West Indies have also moved on to 100.
So Machandra de Silva to Greenwich.
In the air, but safe. And Rumesh Ratnayake out of deep mid on.
That was a pretty good stop by Rumesh Ratnayake. He was sensible enough to push the ball back into the playing area whilst he himself carried on rolling over and over over the boundary line. Had he held onto the ball, of course, that would have counted as four.
The outswinger, and beautifully saved there at point by the fielder there. That's Aravinda De Silva. Is the best fielder at the SCG for Sri Lanka. Doing some good work here again.
Well, it's fairly cold out there at the moment. But fairly hot for Aravinda De Silva. And it's Samachandra De Silva who will be continuing the assault.
That's a good shot from Gordon Greenidge. Wasn't a bad ball at all. But he was very quickly into position. And that's a half century for Gordon Greenidge.
Finickety, Samachandra.
Another boundary as Gordon Greenidge decides he's worked out the wiles of the leg spinner and he's going to do something about changing his length. And I think Greenidge has decided that it's time to get things moving out in the centre.
Sri Lanka ahead of the West Indies at one for 129, but having lost four more wickets.
That'll be cut off. That hit is going into the wind. One in the air. The skipper. Dulip Mendes thought it was going further. I think he started to take off for the deep, but it was a real mishit from Greenwich.
Good performance by Samachandra De Silva again with leg spin.
That's gone away down to square leg and just over the line. Yes, six signalled. So Richie Richardson hitting that one away just behind square on the leg side for six.
De Silva's final over. Strained to leg stump, and he put that away pretty well, hitting with the breeze, almost a gale here at the TCA ground in Hobart.
So Machandra De Silva to Greenwich.
And that's down the ground, high and wide. He's going to be out, is he? Yes, he's caught. Nicely taken down there in the deep. Karupu, the fieldsman down there, moved a long way across to his right and took the catch well.
It was an excellent catch. Gordon Greenwich hitting with the wind, straight down the ground. It was a straight hit, got hold of it. Brendan Karupu coming across, judging it well. It wasn't an easy catch. He caught that brilliantly. In fact, it was a fine outfield catch, and Gordon Greenwich departs into silver strikes. Good spell of leg spin bowling. He's out for 61.
Kaslogi takes strike. Ravi Ratnayake is the bowler.
Oh, that's six. Smashed away right over the top of the scoreboard onto the roof of the indoor centre down there. What a good shot that was. Ravi Ratnayake dropping one short and being dispatched out of the ground.
Kaslogi hitting a real six. That was a boomer. Beautiful hook shot. It was short. He was quickly into position. Hitting with the gale, it went a mile. Beautifully struck. Onto the back foot. Cleared the fence, the shed. There she goes, six Beautiful runs.
And again, short. This time straight to the man down there, well fielded too.
Gus Logie taking strike, Curranane as the bowler.
Oh, and that's a full toss hit straight down the ground. Will it carry the boundary? Not quite. Just short of the boundary. And so four runs to Gus Logie.
Yes, hitting into the gale on that occasion. It was beautifully struck. Picked up the full toss. The wind held it up, but it was a nice stroke. Full face of the bat. Straight hit. Gus Logie really on the boil here. It's good to see. He's been watching Gordon Greenidge struggle. Richie Richardson had no idea against the leg spin of Somachandra De Silva. This young man's come to the crease and played his shots right from the start.
That one down the leg side, and Logie getting it fine and managing to beat the fieldsman down there too. So the runs really are flowing for the West Indies here. And Logie wasting no time. Anything loose or short or even well pitched up, he's smashing away whenever he gets the opportunity. Well, that's going up in the air, but I don't think it's going to get caught landing in the middle of a big vacant area on the ground. A nice throw. That's the end of the over. 2 for 179.
Gus Logie's taking strike. John is the bowler.
Oh, and that smashed away as well. Another six. Well, he likes him in that area. Gus Logie, every time he gets one down there, he hits it down to square leg for six.
And he hits it as clean as a whistle. Picked that up, it was almost a sweep shot. Down on the knee, well over the rope, dropped by the man in the blue tracksuit. This time he works it to square leg just for a single. So Gus Logie giving a fine display, short innings. He goes, there's a man down there, he doesn't get to it, it's four more. Aravinda De Silva straying to leg stump, 11 off the over, 2 for 190. Richardson 49, Logie 32. Manort and John back into the attack, brings up a single which will give Richardson a strike and the opportunity to bring up his 50. Richardson struggled against the leg spinner, but he's played the pace, medium pace bowlers very well. There's his 50. Gentle push through the vacant mid-on position. Comes back for the second, and that's a confidence build for Richie Richardson. Early days in this Benson Hedges World Series Cup. And he's consolidating his form. Applause from Gus Logie, generous applause from this good crowd here in Hobart. And there they go. They've streamed onto the ground. 2 for 198. Richardson 52, Logie 33, extras 19, 2 for 198, and the West Indies win in the canter.
That's a good solid performance from Vivian Richards' team today. A good win and some fine batting by all the men who went in to chase that target of 198. Their scorecard at the end, Greenidge 61 and Haynes 32, and a half century to Richie Richardson, and a good innings from Gus Logie, who came in to take the place of Clive Lloyd, who's not playing in this game. Richards was the acting captain. The bowling figures for the Sri Lankans, not very impressive. I thought the best of them today was probably Rumesh Ratnayake. Somachandra De Silva, the leg spinner, again bowled well. But in all, they did much the same as they did the other day up in Sydney, when they didn't bowl to the field set by their skipper, Duleep Mendes, who, incidentally, later was named player of the match for his fine half-century. He made 56 in the Sri Lankan first innings. So the victory today takes the West Indies on to 4 points in the Benson Hedges World Series Cup table. They have those points from 2 matches. Australia 2 points from 2, and Sri Lanka not yet off the mark. And Sri Lanka and West Indies play at the Gabba on Saturday in the first match of a double header. The second game, the weekend on the Sunday, is completely sold out. That's Australia and the West Indies. So that's not good news for the people who want to go along, but it is good news for those who already have tickets for that game, and what a clash it should be. For the moment then, with the West Indies victors over Sri Lanka here at the TCA Ground Hobart, it's goodbye from Nine's Wide World of Sports.
This has been another presentation from Nine's Wide World of Sports.